This poster advertising Coca-Cola was designed by Penley and was printed in 1996. It's a glossy poster, and you're going to see how we linen-backed this poster today on Poster Fix. This poster was in pretty good condition. It didn't have any wrinkles. It was never folded. It had no pinholes in it. It was in very nice shape. So the customer wanted it put on an archival mounting so that he could frame it. The first thing we have to do is to prepare a screen. We stretch canvas to a frame, and once we've done that, we take a giant sheet of acid-free paper and mount it by using a lot of wheat paste. We apply it to the paper and then attach the paper to the canvas. Once the paper is attached to the canvas, we roll it out to make sure it's good and flat, and we have that screen all ready to go. So now we can mount this poster. I'm putting wheat paste down onto the poster directly because I feel the poster is strong enough to handle it. There are times when I don't do that. I have a different approach, but today we're doing it this way. The poster is absorbing the wheat paste, and once it's absorbed long enough, I flip it over and paste it down to the acid-free paper. Once it's down there, I push out the air pockets to make sure it's good and flat on the paper before going into it with a roller. Now with a roller, I gently roll it out very carefully. I'm concerned about the poster getting dinged or damaged by the roller because glossy posters are frequently very sensitive. But this poster seems to be responding very well, and it's adhering to the acid-free paper very well. There's no damage, and there doesn't seem to be any disagreeable reaction to the linen backing. So it's safe to back this poster. The poster is now linen backed to this acid-free paper and cotton canvas, and we're going to let it dry for a few days before we trim it down. A few days have passed, and now we're trimming down the poster. I like to leave extra backing border around the poster. That way, the framer has the option of how much they want to trim off, depending on how much overlap they need in the frame. There were a few areas of the poster that had color missing in some spots from previous damage, which I didn't really notice until now because the poster is flat and it's easier to see them. Also, the design of the poster helps to hide any imperfections there are in there, so you really have to look carefully to find damage. And I did find a few spots of white that needed to have color retouched. So that's what I'm doing now. And these are watercolor markers I'm using, water reversible and archival. Well, the poster's finished. This is the completed Coca-Cola poster, a nice glossy poster by artist Penley, printed in Canada and published in 1996. Having linen-backed posters for 36 years, I can tell you that this has come out very, very nicely, a very cooperative glossy poster. Advertising Coca-Cola, the pause that refreshes, things go better with Coke. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, make sure to send me an email. Tell me their size, the description of the poster, a description of the condition, and send me a few pictures if you can. That'll help me determine a price on the linen backing of your vintage poster. And I look forward to hearing from you. Thank you very much.